Oh, hello everyone. Test, test, 1, 2, 3. Making sure if my mic works. I thought it wouldn't work for a minute or two.
But, oh my. I couldn't even believe it's already been a year since we have our very first Spooktown reaction blog. And now, since it's our second annual Spooktown reaction blog for this time of the year, and for this Halloween season, we're not going to react just to the videos. We have so many amazing Halloween activities, so that way you won't have to miss them for sure. And for President Slappy Quackintosh, get it up.
That's right. Now this is our second year of Spooktown reaction blog this time of the season. We're doing more than just the video reaction. We're having all the crossovers of every fandom to be in the same series with us this year. Isn't that right, Flippy?
So this has already been a year, and it's really Nishiko's idea. I really believe that everybody else should have a second chance to see every single fandom that she had to pick, and we all have to pick.
Absolutely right.
Okay. Does anything else that you guys are mentioning our stars feel somewhat nostalgic somehow?
Exactly.
Accurately, it's already been a year since her very first appearance, and along with three amazing characters, Flippy, Slappy, and Mew Ichigo from different worlds, and they agree into having her react to this video.
No.
That's right. We react our very first video, and that turned out to be the clock collector made by Foreman himself.
That's really understandable, and I love it. And I hope we can still continue on as best we can. And we'll try our best to cheer everyone up all the way through. And hopefully we can extend this whole series through until Thanksgiving. And without further ado, let's welcome Mishkan!
Hello everyone! My name is Mishka, Mish for short, and welcome back to Spooktown's reaction blog.
Hi everybody!
Hi! Okay. We're back!
Now we're all here. Are you guys ready?
I am well prepared.
What about me, Mishkan?
Video starts in 3, 2, 1.
Oh, that's House of Mouse, House of Melons.
That's Minnie Mouse.
Oh, Ursula.
I remember this since it first came out.
Nya.
Jafar and Iago.
And I remember Captain Hook.
Captain Hook.
And that's Mickey Mouse there. Corral the Bill.
Yikes. Like, zoinks. I knew they were about to sing.
This could be quite the place.
I'm glad that the cogs are not into their party.
Inside this evil joint.
Oh my god, this is not good.
That's Pete? Oh my. The love is from Sleeping Beauty.
And that's the Queen of Hearts.
They literally pump their fists up in the air.
Aren't they?
Yeah. All the characters were captured. Where everybody? In the end, everything gets sorted out.
I couldn't believe this is gonna be really spooky than I ever even expect. And I can't even imagine this. Oh.
Right. Now you know how I feel, Mishkan.
Well, you and me both, Camellia.
Now everyone, I understand how you feel, but this happened way back in the middle 2000s, and this whole villain situation has already been resolved back in the House of Mouse. And the rest is history. But there is one little question that still ponders me to this day.
Do tell, Dubbity. Go ahead.
Well, before I can easily manage to do some schedule for the next Spooktense reaction blocks, and especially some Halloween festivities for sure, I have this question that's still pondering to this day, and it's for Flippy and Slappy. Since you knew about the House of Villains, but I have to ask, how did the villains manage to roughly ban the other teen species and take away their conjures just long before both Verin and Corporal Clash teams finally got them unbanned and get them back in the community?
Roughly banned it?
I never recall about these villains roughly banning the Toons. In fact, once I appeared back in 2003, I was only focusing on the clock since it's already run amok. That's just it. That was almost 2 decades ago.
None of us don't know how they easily got roughly banned it for no reason. Every single election, we had to convince one species after the other to come back to our world. It's like no matter what we do, they just easily get shut out. But the truth is, you can only have one per species or the other into coming in. Now we have both crocodiles and deers, only rewritten. There's so many species in Corporate Clash. Only depending on the way how they're acting, we can only sense that. And as for the cogs, they are starting to get along as much as I already know so far. But it's like every time both sides really want to work together, they got framed for no reason just like I did. Which is a long darn story cut short. It's hard to recap, but I think Mishka can handle it. Right, Mishka? 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 Where did she go?
She had to get ready for work, so this Mew Ichigo. However, we'll have to get ready for the next episode if we want to make everything all happy and spectacular.
Precisely. But in the meantime, we'll be right back after the break. But in the meantime, we also have some spooky duets that Mishka did from TikTok on her channel. And of course, last but certainly not the least, Mishka's going to be in homeschooling at the moment this time. Every Mondays and Tuesdays, but yet, the only thing is, she's going to be planning to have some awareness here on our series. Once you see the WIP right above or in the description, she'll get back to update in advance.
See you all very soon, everybody. Stay tuned, and we'll show you.